Dear students, welcome. This is our 10th class on dynamics. Today, we shall try to solve this problem. What is it? Assuming that a particle falling freely under gravity can penetrate the earth without meeting any resistance. So that a particle falling from rest at a distance b, b is greater than a, from the center of the earth would on reaching the center acquire a velocity d, and the time to travel from the surface to the center of the earth is this, where a is the radius of the earth. You see here, b is greater than a means the particle is moving outside the surface of the earth. A is the radius of the earth and g is the acceleration due to gravity on the earth surface. Let us proceed. Suppose this is earth. Who is the center of the earth? Suppose who is the center of the earth? A is the radius of the earth. We draw a vertical line OB. Draw O to meet the surface of the earth at A. You see here, a particle is falling from rest at a distance b from the center of the earth. A particle is falling from rest means at the point b, the velocity of the particle is b. It is moving downwards. Suppose p is the position of the particle at time t, where op equal to x, op equal to x, and the a is the radius of the earth. This means this is equal to A. A is the radius of the earth. This is equal to A. Particle is moving from rest from the point B up to A under the acceleration mu by x square. Because a particle, if a particle moves outside the surface of the earth, acceleration varies inversely as the distance of the particle from the center of the earth. And inside the surface, inside the earth, then acceleration varies directly as the distance of the particle from the center of the earth. Let me write first. Let O be the center of the earth. And A be the radius of the earth. A be the radius of the earth. We draw a vertical line OB through O to meet the surface of the earth at A. We draw a vertical line. OB through O to meet the surface of the earth. Earth at A. O A equal to A. Now O A is equal to A. O A equal to A equal to radius of the earth. A particle is falling from the point B. From B, where OB equal to B, it is given in the equation, at the distance B from the center of the earth. OB is equal to B. Let P be the position of the particle. At time t, where OP equal to, H. Acceleration of the particle at P is mu by x square towards O. Particle at P is mu by x square towards O. The equation of motion of the particle is the equation of motion of the particle is x double dot means d2x by dt square equal to minus mu by x square. Acceleration is this towards O negative sign mu by x square. This equation holds good for the motion of the particle from B to A. Suppose this is the equation 1 holds good for the motion of the particle from B to A. For the motion of the particle from B to A, for the motion of the particle from B to A, the equation 1 holds good for the motion of the particle from B to A. Now, at the earth surface A, Now at the earth surface A, d2x by dt square, you see d2x by dt square is nothing but x double dot, equal to minus z, x equal to OA equal to E. Therefore, one implies minus z equal to minus mu by a square. This means mu equal to z a square. Therefore, one can be written as. Therefore, one becomes. d2x by dt square equal to minus z a square by x square. Z square divided by x. This is number two. Multiplying 2 by two times of dx dt we get. d2x by dt square equal to minus 2 times of z square by x square dx by dt. ddt of dx by dt whole square equal to, this can be written as twice z square, it is constant, d dt of x to the power minus 1 by, just integrate this, x to the power minus 2, x to the power minus 1 by minus 1. Therefore, if you differentiate this, you will get this one. This is the case. This means d dt of dx dt whole square equal to d dt of this minus 1 minus 1, if you multiply it, it will be plus 1 twice z square divided by, not x square, it is x. Twice z square divided by x. Suppose this is number 3. Not 3, you need not write. Integrating we get. Integrating we get dx by dt whole square equal to twice z square divided by x plus c1. C1 is the constant of integration. Where c1 is the constant of integration? Where c1 is the constant of integration? Now, the particle was falling from the point B towards A. Up to from B to A, this equation holds good from B to A. At the point B, the velocity of the particle dx dt, dx by dt is equal to 0. And then x is equal to b, it is given in the equation. At the distance b from the center of the arc. But initially, at the point b, dh by dt equal to 0, at the point b, velocity equal to 0, and x equal to b, therefore you may write here this number 3. Therefore from 3 you will get 0 equal to twice z a square by b plus c1. This means c1 is equal to minus twice z a square divided by b. Substitute the value of c1 in 3. Substituting the value of this value of c1 in 3 we get, substituting this value of c1 in 3 we get dx by dt whole square. This is equal to twice g a square by x minus twice g a square divided by b. Suppose this is number 2. This is number 2. You see, the particle is falling from the point B under the acceleration varies inversely as the square of the distance of the particle from the center of force, center of the earth. It holds good from B to A. From A to O, it will move under the acceleration such that acceleration varies directly as the distance of the particle from the center of the earth. Therefore, we must find the velocity of the particle at the point A. Suppose V is the velocity of the particle at the earth surface A. Suppose let V be the velocity of the particle. Particle F A on the earth surface. Give me the velocity of the particle F A, that is on the earth surface. Therefore, but at the point A, what is x? X is equal to A, but at the point A. X equal to OA, this is equal to A. Therefore, putting dx by dt equal to V, x is equal to A, we get the velocity of the particle at the point A. On the earth surface. Therefore, putting dx by dt equal to V, and x equal to a in 4, we get the velocity of the particle at the point A. Means you put here it is equal to v square is equal to twice z a square divided by a minus twice z a square by b. This means you will get V square is equal to twice Z square 1 by A minus 1 by B. V square is equal to this. This means V equal to root over, you may write root over twice Z square 1 by A minus 1 by B. This is the velocity of the particle at the point A. Right? Now, the particle moves, assuming that a particle falling freely under gravity can penetrate the earth without making any resistance, it will come B to A under the rule under the acceleration mu divided by x square, then it will moving, it will be moving from A to O also under the acceleration. Suppose lambda divided by x, lambda into x, not divided by x, lambda into x, because the acceleration varies directly as the distance of the particle from the center of the earth. Now you may write here motion of the particle, motion from A to O, motion from A to O. The velocity of the particle at A is given by phi. At A is V. V is given by phi. When the particle moves from A to O leg, this time you may write y or x, it will not matter. Let x be the distance of the particle. Distance of the particle from O. From O means from the center of the earth. The equation of motion of the particle, the equation of motion of the particle from A to O is given by x double dot means d2x by dt square equal to lambda x minus lambda x. This is equal to minus lambda x. Suppose this is number 6, but at the earth surface acceleration is equal to minus z, x equal to OA, but at the earth surface A. But at the earth surface at the earth surface here, that is at A, earth surface, d2x by dt square equal to minus z, x equal to a. Therefore, from 6 you will get minus, this is equal to z by a. 6 implies, substitute the value of lambda, therefore 6 implies d2x by dt square equal to minus z by a h. This equation holds good from, for the motion of the particle from A to O. The equation 7 holds good, you may write, the equation 7 holds good for the motion of the particle from A to O, for the motion of the particle from A to O. Now this will be required, therefore I should not remove this one. V equal to twice z a square into 1 by a minus 1 by b, it will be applied later on. V equal to this will be applied later on. Now multiply 7 by 7, multiplying 7 by 2 times of dx dt we get, 2 times of dx dt, d2x dt square equal to minus 2z by a x dx dt. This means d dt of dx dt whole square will be equal to what is the integration of twice x? X square. Therefore, you may write here d dt of minus z by a x square. Can I write like this? Differentiate this twice x dx dt. Therefore, integrating we get. Integrating we get. Integrating we get dx by dt whole square equal to minus z by a x square plus c2. C2 is the constant of integration. Suppose this is number 8, but at the point A it is moving from A to O this time. But at the point A, dx dt is given by b, given by 5. What is b? Root over twice z square into 1 by a minus 1 by b. What is x? X is equal to a. But at the point A, but initially at a, dx dt, this is equal to v. V is given by root over this. Twice z square 1 by a minus 1 by b. X equal to, at the point a, x is equal to a, and this x is equal, and x is equal to a. Substitute dx dt is equal to this, x is equal to a, in 8 we get, therefore 8 becomes, from 8 we get, substituting this, in 8 we get, therefore from 8 you will get, it is b square, means twice z a square 1 by a minus 1 by b, this is equal to minus z by a into a square plus c2. Or you may write here twice z a minus twice z a square by b equal to minus z a plus c2. Therefore c2 will be equal to, c2 is equal to thrice z a minus twice z a square divided by b. Thrice z a minus twice z a square divided by b. Now substitute this value of c2 in 8. Now substituting this value of c2 in 8 we get. Now substituting this value of c2. In 8 we get dx dt whole square equal to minus z by a x square plus thrice z a minus twice z a square divided by b. Right? What is this? This gives the velocity of the particle. When it moves or it is moving from A to O, it gives the velocity of the particle at any distance x from the center of the earth. From the center of the earth, the velocity is given by this. Velocity given by this when it is at the distance x from the center of the earth. When the particle moves from A to O, right? Now, when it reaches the center, we have to find the velocity of the particle. With velocity of the particle at the center of the earth, we have to find the velocity of the particle at the center of the earth. How can it be evaluated? Put dx dt equal to Suppose V0 is the velocity of the particle when it reaches the center of the Earth. Then what will be the value of x? X will be equal to 0. Because when the particle arrives at the center O, the distance of the particle from O will be equal to 0. Let V0 be the velocity of the particle. Let V0 be the velocity of the particle. When it reaches the, it is 9, when it reaches, down center of the Earth, therefore, putting dx dt equal to v0, x equal to 0 in 9, we get v0 square equal to 0 plus 3ga minus twice g a square divided by b. This means v0 square equal to ga by b 3b minus twice a. If you take ga common and also 1 by b common, then it will be thrice b minus twice a. This means v0 equal to ga by b thrice b minus twice a. This is the velocity of the particle at the center of the Earth. You see here, it has been proved. First part has been proved. This is equal to, what is this? This is equal to the velocity of the particle at the center of the Earth. This is equal to the velocity of the particle. Velocity of the particle at the center of the Earth. Velocity of the particle at the center of the Earth. We know this with this. One part has been proved. Now we are going to find the second part. What is it? We are to find the time taken by the particle from A to O. You see, the time to travel from the surface to the center of the Earth is this. We are to find the time taken by the particle from the surface of the Earth to the center of the Earth. Second part. What is second part? We have to find the time taken. Let t0 be the time taken by the particle. t0 be the time taken by the particle from A to O, that is from the surface of the Earth to the center of the Earth. From A to O means from the surface of the Earth to the center of the Earth. t0 is the time taken. Now 9 implies. Now from 9 you will get dx by dt whole square equal to you may ga by b thrice b minus twice a minus g by a into x square. You may write like this. Am I right? From 9 you will get this one. Or you may write dx by dt whole square equal to, you may take g by a common, That's z by a common. Then, or if this z by a common, therefore, you will have to write a by z into z by a b into thrice b minus twice a minus x square. You may write like this. Which means dx dt whole square, dx by dt whole square equal to z by a, here z cancel, a square by b, a square by b thrice b minus twice a minus x square. You may write like this. This is z by a. This means dx by dt equal to minus root over z by a into root over, again root over, a square by b thrice b minus twice a minus x square. The negative sign has been taken because the particle is moving in a direction of x decreasing. It is moving in a direction of x decreasing. You may write here the negative sign has been taken. The negative sign has been taken. Since the particle is moving in a direction of x decreasing, the negative sign has been taken because the particle is moving in the direction of x decreasing. Now this means minus root over z by a dt equal to dx divided by under root you may write a square by b thrice b minus twice a, you may write under root also square also has been given. Suppose this is number 10. Integrating 10 we get. From A to O we get. We are integrating 10. A to O. Integration minus root over z by A dt. T equal to 0 to T naught, because from at the point A the time is equal to 0. At the point O total time taken by the particle from A to O has been taken as T naught. Therefore 0 to T naught equal to integration root of R integration dx by root of R a square by b thrice b minus twice a, it is whole square also given and the root over sign has also been given. This is equal to this. X equal to at the point A, what is x? X is equal to O A equal to A. It is x is equal to A. When it arrives at the point O, x becomes 0, therefore it is 0. X is equal to. Now, if you interchange the limit, then the negative sign will be removed. This means t equal to 0 to t naught, root over z by a dt equal to 0 to a dx divided by under root, again under root, a square by b thrice b minus twice e whole square minus x square. Now, root of r z by a, it is t naught minus 0 t naught. This is equal to, or t naught minus 0, you may write like this. What is this? It is of the form integration 1 by root of r a square minus x square. Simply sine inverse x by a, sine inverse x by a. Sine inverse x divided by a. What is a here? A is equal to under root x square by b, thrice b minus twice a. And it is 0 to e. It is 0 to e. This means root of r z by e t naught, this is equal to sine inverse a divided by, this a can be taken outside this, thrice b minus twice a divided by b, you may write like this, minus sine inverse 0, minus sine inverse 0, right? A will be cancelled, a will be cancelled. This means t naught equal to root of r a by z, root of r a by z, sine inverse b divided by thrice b minus twice a under root, under root. Minus 0 sine inverse 0 is equal to 0. This means t naught equal to. This means t naught equal to root of r a by z. A by z sine inverse b divided by thrice b minus twice e, and it is also under root. Total time taken by the particle from A to O means from the surface of the earth to the center of the earth. It has also been proved. The second part has also been proved. Dear student, it is very easy. Not tough, it is easy. Perhaps you have understood this and you have enjoyed the class. Thanks for attending the class. Thank you very much. Thank you.